Before you can file and pay with Webfile, we must verify that your e-systems profile is authorized to access confidential tax account information. This video will explain how we authenticate tax account access, where to find your Texas taxpayer number and Webfile number, and what to do if you cannot locate these numbers. Check the video description for links to the tools we will reference in this and other Webfile tutorials. In order to authenticate access to a tax account in Webfile, we require the Texas taxpayer number and a unique code, which we refer to as a Webfile number. Both numbers are issued by the Comptroller's office. Your Webfile number is a security measure that prevents someone else from filing a tax return with your Texas taxpayer number, similar to the way a PIN protects access to a bank account. Your Webfile number is only known to you and the Comptroller's office. If you choose someone else to manage your tax filings with Webfile, you will need to provide them with your Webfile number. Otherwise, do not share your Webfile number. Now that you know your Texas taxpayer number and Webfile number work together to protect your confidential account information, let's take a look at where these numbers are located. Webfile numbers are different for every tax type per Texas taxpayer number. Both the Texas taxpayer number and the corresponding unique Webfile number are printed on returns and notices mailed by our office to the address on file. Texas taxpayer numbers are 11 digits and begin with either a 3 or 1. Webfile numbers contain 8 characters. They begin with 2 letters followed by 6 digits. For sales and use tax, as well as most tax and fee types, the Webfile number begins with RT and is printed in the upper left-hand margin of the pre-printed return. The taxpayer number is located in the form field, item C, just below the report title. Franchise tax Webfile numbers begin with XT and are printed on the right-hand side of the notification letter from our office. The taxpayer number is the 11-digit number located above it. Some business entities, including those newly registered with the Texas Secretary of State, may receive a letter from the Comptroller containing a Webfile number that begins with FQ. This access code is needed to file the franchise tax questionnaire and cannot be used to file franchise tax returns or extensions to make payments. Now that you have your 11-digit Texas taxpayer number and the Webfile number of the tax type you would like to manage, you're ready to authenticate access in your e-systems profile. Check the video description for a link to that tutorial. If you're still missing one or both of these numbers, the rest of this video will show you alternate retrieval methods. Feel free to use the timestamps in the video description to skip ahead to the information you need. There are a couple of ways to retrieve your Texas taxpayer number, online and by phone. We'll explain each option, starting with sales and most other tax and fee types, before reviewing the same options for franchise tax. Go to the Comptroller's homepage at comptroller.texas.gov. In the Business Center module under the Look It Up section, click the Sales Taxpayer Search link. This database allows you to look up a sales tax number by an entity's 9-digit Federal Employer Identification Number, or FEIN, the name of a business at a particular location, the name of the individual who owns the business, and the legal name of the business entity. Name search fields accept full or partial names. The zip code is useful for narrowing the search if the results yield too many matches. This tool also supports populating one or more fields to see more specific results. Search results will provide the legal name of the business entity under the taxpayer name, the principal legal mailing address of the business, the city, state, and zip code in which the business is legally located, and the 11-digit Texas taxpayer number. For security reasons, this field may be blank for some taxpayers. You can sort each of these fields in ascending or descending order by clicking on the column headings or using the drop-down menu. If the taxpayer number is associated with a different tax or fee, you can search Comptroller records of license and permit holders. On the Comptroller's homepage, in the Business Center module under the Look It Up section, click the Practitioner's Corner link. This page includes links to more searchable databases for other tax and fee types. If you still can't find your Texas taxpayer number for sales and most other tax and fee types, please contact us by phone at 1-800-252-5555. Now let's review the options for retrieving a Texas taxpayer number for franchise tax, first online, then by phone. Go to the Comptroller's homepage at comptroller.texas.gov. In the Business Center module under the Look It Up section, click the Franchise Tax Account Status link. This database allows you to look up a franchise tax number by an entity's 9-digit Federal Employer Identification Number, or FEIN, the name of the business entity, or the entity's Texas Secretary of State file number. Populate only one field per search. If entering the FEIN doesn't yield results, try the other search fields. The FEIN may not be listed with a franchise tax account. Search results will provide the legal name of the business entity, the 11-digit Texas taxpayer number, and the zip code of the entity's mailing address on file with our office. If you still can't find your Texas franchise taxpayer number, please contact us by phone at 1-800-252-1381. Once you've identified your Texas taxpayer number, you'll also need the corresponding Webfile number to establish access to the tax account on your eSystems profile. If you're unable to locate your Webfile number, please contact us at 1-800-442-3453. You'll be asked to provide confidential account information, such as prior return data or prior payment, in addition to your Texas taxpayer number. We have more Webfile videos to better serve you. Check the video description for links. If you need further assistance, we're happy to help. Please reach out to us by email or phone. Our contact information is also available in the description.